with the number of units here, Tim's required to put two parking spaces in the back here. That's part of the original plan. The plot plan showed it. And this is the final element to completing this project. Our task here is to create some two parking places, and it must be permeable paving. So what that means is water will hit this, whatever we put in here, and filter through it and go back to the Mother Earth. And it doesn't have to be dealt with by the storm water system. Water off the roofs can go to a downspout, to a pipe that takes it to the street. That's okay. But they don't want us making more of a problem back here. We need to deal with it ourselves. That involves making permeable parking spaces here. We need to dig down probably about 8 inches or so. Some filter fabric down there to keep the dirt from getting in. I will put some round rock in here, and round rock maintains the voids around it, which means water will flow through it. Okay, when it's in this hole, it really can't go anywhere. That's usually the problem with round rock or open rock. We'll put that down, and then we'll place these pavers over the top of that. These pavers are almost 2 inches thick. Sometimes with these little projects, you think logistics, right? We're kind of in tight quarters and we want to be as efficient as possible. I cannot get all of this dirt in one trip. We load it up, we take it to a Lane Forest Products around here. They'll take the dirt and they sell the gravel that we need. They sell the rock that we need. So the most efficient operation is I bring rock back with me. So our plan here, we've dug half of this out, put our filter fabric down. On our way back, we'll bring 3 or 4 yards of rock back with us. We'll dump it right here and just stockpile it, basically. This is where it's gonna have to go. Then we'll dig the rest, get it in the trailer, spread this gravel as far as it will go. And then bring it back with us, and basically we've made two trips so far, two round trips, and then the last one will be the trip with the material that fills up the egg crate plastic beauty box. One challenge we have is this concrete. Well, it's a cleanout. It's for the sewer. It is too low. You know, we digested this thing, and no pun intended, but we've contacted the city to say, hey, can we raise this thing up? It's a metal ring, and it's got concrete poured around it. Here is the 6-inch plastic clean out PVC. So it is into this ring is independent of that clean out. We should be able to just slide this up 4 inches and repack around it, and everything will be hunky-dory. That's the dream. So we start there and see what we wind up with. It's possible we break that and they'll have to give us a new ring and we can move forward concrete around it. We addressed the situation of this. It's a clean out. This is just a clean out for the sewer, 6-inch PVC pipe. And this is the protective ring that they put over it so people can drive back and forth in the alley and not obviously wreck the PVC pipe. Well, this was too low. We needed it to be up about 4 inches higher than it was to get so it isn't lower than our pavers or our permeable paving. Tim had taken pictures of it before when the sewer was being hooked up. Good for him, because we had a good idea of what it looked like, because the side of it was exposed. He asked the city if it were possible to raise that. They said, go ahead. You know, this is just a piece of, it must be 30 inch plastic culvert, two rings worth. They chopped that, they put that around, and there's a metal ring here that actually goes around the PVC pipe itself. That maintains access to that PVC forever and ever, ideally. So anyway, we investigated, dug around it to make sure it wasn't gonna break anything, picked it up with a dingo, added some gravel around it. Now we're gonna place it back in there, try to get it level, and make sure that that PVC will stay in the center. Obviously, if we're offset, they'll never get the lid off. So we have to do our job here. We'll get it set there the way we like it. We'll stomp up and down on it, and we'll pack around the perimeter of it real good with rock so it can't move. And it'll be a lovely thing when we're done. Okay, so our goal here is to come up with a happy medium of where we want these things to be. I mean, what do we want the grade to be? We have a sidewalk there that we poured with this in mind. We're gonna have to have one step up from the pavers onto that sidewalk. Remember, minimum riser height is 4 inches, so that's what we're gonna shoot for, a minimum of 4 inches. Obviously, we can't be a lot higher than the alley. Otherwise, this stuff would slough off into the alley. We come up with a height. We set up our laser, set our rod to indicate the bottom of our pole. Okay, it's 8 inches below where the top of the finished product wants to be.
And what are you doing, Paul?
I am checking grade. We want this to be a level. We're shooting for level from one side to the other. I like using a level for this because this is an eye. This reads the beam on the laser. This is old fashioned. I'll show you. This is an old dumb thing. Anyway, it's receiving the beam on this end. So I have to keep that pointed towards the laser. And there's an arrow that tells me if I need to go up or down. This is perfect. You know, arrow shows down, I go down, and then the two lines there tell me I'm right where I need to be. If it's too low, the arrow says go up. We can turn the sound on, which is the most annoying thing in the world. fast beep tells us to go down, slow beep tells us to go up. I turn it off because that's about as much of that as I can handle. We need to place just a little more gravel from the trailer here, trying to get it as good as we can get it. You know, we're doesn't have to be perfect, but we're shooting for as good as we can get. The only way to really, for me, us to get this any better would be to put screed boards up here and actually rot it off like we're rotting off concrete with a screed board. Keep a little material in front of it and keep working our way back. Then it would be perfect. I don't know. I don't want to say this doesn't warrant us putting all that effort into it, but I made the decision last night that we'll be really close. I'll use the machine to float this off and get it looking really nice. Then we'll compact it again. This will lay on top of our round rock, and we'll put, I forget, you know, quarter inch crushed, ideally crushed open, on here, flush with the top of this plastic. So this grid keeps that crushed rock from displacing, keeps it in place, keeps the round rock underneath, the porous rock underneath from shoving around. And anyway, so these are 2x2 squares. They're like little blocks that link together. I think we're going close to 40 feet by 8 feet wide.
44, I think.
Yeah. 44 by 8. And that would be enough for 2 cars to park. Okay.
The last couple of them. And this is a high industrial true grid pavers. Like dump trucks and those kind of things are supposed to be able to go on this stuff and have no problem.
Yes, but we don't want any dump trucks.
No.
All right. Job. And then we'll go get some gravel, and we'll get quarter inch, I don't remember if it's quarter inch minus 10.
Quarter ten.
It's very small stuff that will fill in those 8-crate type plastic deal, flush with the top of those. There, just to recap, kind of put a period on this thing. We got all the gravel in here. This egg crate type stuff is keeping this gravel where it's supposed to be. That's the idea. We've created a permeable paving system, and it'll, you know, flatten out this gravel, settle a little more probably. We did compact this gravel after we put the quarter ten or whatever. This product, the paver material, the plastic components, the grid came with these little yellow dealy bobs. You can sort of delineate parking spaces, make sure your neighbor's not parking in your spot. These will be tricky parking places. You know, you're gonna have to probably drive this way so you can see when you're backing in, practice your parallel parking. Or so, you know, 2 little cars here ought to work fine. Did raise this clean out for the sewer hook up, and they came by, apparently the city did, and blessed it. They said good job. It's always good to hear that versus why did you, you know, what did you, how did you, know, having somebody throw their arms up at you. You know, one of the big deals with creating these middle housing is the, you know, where do we put our car issue, and that the rules have been relaxed and that has allowed this to occur. But you know, we've got to be creative about how we do this. So, you know, alley access. Now the alley probably need to be, you know, maintained maybe a little more than it was before, because it will be somebody's route to their car. And Tim does it all. Look, he's got reserve parking, 1106A, 1108A. I mean, he's being a good landlord, I suppose, or owner, providing their be no, you know, no discretion. I mean, it is clear what should happen here. So good for him. He's trying to make his life easy by doing everything he can on this end. Thank you.